I'll start it.
Now can you
Yeah, now
listen
can
to
you hear
me?
me?
Can you listen to me? Yes.
Great. That.
Yes. Okay. Okay, so again, welcome back. My name is Shailesh Sharaf. I am the director of Dynamic Equities Private Limited. Our website is dynamiclevels.com. And we wanted to share our views on the what happens after the budget, what does the market look like after the budget. So basically, 1st February, the market was 8538. In 6 days, the market has gone drastically up to about 8814 high. It has risen about approximately 300 points. Bank Nifty has risen by 1,000 points. Okay.
Russian gen is not.
Okay, so rest, Roshan, maybe you have an issue with your computer. Everybody can hear me? Can I have a raise of hands again? Yes, yeah. So Roshan, it's the computer. Okay, so the small cap index was 63. It rose by 360 points, right? And even the mid cap index has risen by about 500. There has been a rise of about 4% in the Indian indices in the last 6 days. That means there has been a huge buying in the market going on in the stock markets. And the sectors, again, this is all from 1st February low. Again, the sugar sector has been doing well since the decontrol in 2015. It is again, one of the most important sectors. You should have some investment in this sector. The PSU banks have been doing very well. Transportation, logistics have done very well because they've increased the infrastructure spending on roads development. So paper is still doing well. Fertilizers, because the government is very highly focused on agriculture. So fertilizers are doing well. Food industry is doing well. So we should again, just want to emphasize that you should always know which sectors are doing well. Okay, and from those sectors, you should pick up your stocks to have greater returns in the market. So sectoral knowledge is very, very critical. So if you observe, these are the five sectors, but other sectors have also moved up, the cements, financial services. Basically, the markets have up. So these sectors are up. Sectors which have not been performing, auto, no performance in auto. Very surprising. So after the budget, from after the budget, there is no performance in the auto sector. IT sector is down, because of the H-1B visas. So there is issue related to it. There is a lot of Trump has given, in the parliament, so in the Senate. So if it gets passed, then the IT industry is badly hit. So it is not performing that much. So basically, these are the sectors which has been performing a great one. So after the budget, so you should keep an eye on these sectors. Okay? So these are the buzzing sectors after post-budget. Now, which are the shares which has been performing? So we have a list of about 150 good shares which has good fundamentals. So which are the shares? In the last 6-7 days, Aegis Chem, one of a fantastic share in transportation logistics, has risen by about 40%, approximately 40% in 7 days. So it's a great share. It is already risen. It has few. We'll discuss more on the thing. We have the detail, right?
Yeah.
The PA, EPS, everything. So with this, we are only covering the cash market here. We are not covering the futures market. So there are many, many shares in the PSU area, in the futures market, which is also doing very, very well. One of the shares which is not in the futures but in cash is Vijaya Bank, which has also risen a lot. Then Rain Metals and Mining, K in infrastructure, chemicals, media, financial services. Dhampur Sugar is a great buy. West Coast Paper is a great buy. Out Sugar, Dwarke Sugar, I recommend that you should have some investments in these shares, definitely. But these shares are continuously going up. Right? So there should be, Again, I repeat, you should have a great knowledge of the sector, which sectors are doing well. That is the key. So if you know, that with these sectors are doing well, then you can put your investments in those sectors. Okay. Be balanced, you know, at least have in your portfolio, at least have 10, 15 sectors which are doing well and invest in those sectors. Right? As I shared, after budget, the sugar shares are still up. Sugar shares have been up since the last 1.5, 2 years. So, and still it is a great investment because the P ratio is still very, very low. Dhampur Sugar, the P ratio is 6.8, Out Sugar 2, Dwarke Sugar 4. See what happened after a huge time, they went after the decontrol. So these companies are doing very well now. It still has a huge upside, right? Like Dhampur Sugar has 25 investment, 63 institutions have investment in Dhampur Sugar. So it's a very, very good share. You know, I would rather definitely recommend to invest in Dhampur Sugar because there are a lot of institutions. That means the debt equity ratio is also very, very low. So Dhampur Sugar is a fantastic buy, which I highly recommend still because the P ratio is still 6.8. And even after budget, it is still going up. So sector knowledge and then the share knowledge, when you mix both of them together, you'll have a great understanding of the market. Right. Again, the banks are up. You know, as we have not covered the banks here because this is we are investing most in the stock in the cash markets. Okay, so you know, so Vijaya Bank, Indian Bank are still doing very well. These two shares are doing very, very well. Okay, even after budget, the banking shares have done very well. You know, one of the reason is the banks have a great liquidity now, you know, because of demonetization. And they've also, because they have also, you know, started to reduce lending rate, which affects their profitability, but the demand is very high. So because the demands are very high and there is surplus liquidity to give it to the businesses, in the budget, the mid sector, the tax has been reduced to 25%. So banks have done very well after budget. So we have to see this. Another area, the transportation and logistics, the infrastructure spending has been increased tremendously. In the budget, 19,000 crore for Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana. Okay, rural electrification 100% by 2018. Okay, there is an app also which is made. What is an app? No, the app of the electricity. There's an app of the electricity where you can track how many villages have been electrified. You know, electricity has gone to those villages. Okay, sanitation coverage has increased now. The total allocation to the infrastructure is huge. 396,000 crore to the infrastructure. So that's a great area. The transportation logistics. One company which is doing very well is Aegis Chemical. There are 94 institutions have bought this share, but the only concern is that the P ratio is very, very high. So you wait for it. Whenever you see there is a pullback, then you invest in the share. So you can invest in the share at the rate of 130, 140 because the P ratio is very, very high. Okay, so we have to be careful when the P ratio is very, very high. Okay. Now again, the paper companies after budget, it has increased by 20%. West Coast Paper, JK Paper are doing very well. Again, if you see the P/E ratio is very, very low. So it has a great upside. West Coast Paper, JK Paper has a great upside. Even if you see in the, you know, paper industry again has the fourth best performing industry after budget. Okay, fertilizers is a favorite counter. Again, fertilizers are beautiful. So in the budget, a dedicated micro irrigation fund will be set up for NABARD at 5,000 crore initial surplus. Irrigation corpus increased from 20,000 crore to 40,000 crores. That's a huge jump. So the fertilizer, all the company which is related to fertilizer, and a sum of rupees 10 lakh crore is allocated as credit to farmers with 60 days interest waiver. So that means they can buy more seeds, more fertilizers, they can increase their irrigation, the agriculture, which the government has a very, very big scope. So Sambal Fertilizer, Deepak Fertilizer, and one of the best stocks which has been doing very well is GNFC, GSFC also. And if you see the P ratio, okay, so Chambal Fertilizer, don't invest because the P ratio is very, very high. But if you see GNFC, Coromandel, I highly recommend, that you can invest in GNFC. We have been seeing its performance. It's doing very, very well and also has a very huge number of institutions. Okay, so the government focus is very strong on the fertilizer sector. It is the fifth highest sector which is increasing. So you can invest in GNFC because the P ratio is very, very low. Also GSFC. Okay. So after budget, they are still going up. So that's a great sign. FMCG food. Again, in GST, I think so there will be no tax on, there will be no GST on food and dairy products. It will be zero. So there are certain shares which is going up, Prabhat, Heritage Food. But again, the P ratio is very high. So Heritage Food is a great stock, but the P ratio is very high, so you have to be careful. KRBL is actually a rice company. KRBL is a rice company, okay, and quality. So there are some good stocks which has a potential to go up, in the dairy companies. Again, pharma. Be very careful where the P ratio is very high. We are just showing you that which shares have risen after budget. But we are also giving a warning signal that you cannot invest. If you have to choke check, invest between Morpen Lab and Jubilant, which one will you invest? Definitely Jubilant because it has a P ratio of only 22. Right? So it is definitely better. But we are just showing you that which shares have risen after. So Morpen Lab has risen, but definitely invest in Jubilant, which has a P ratios of 22. Okay, Dishman, Suven, so these pharma companies are also be rising after the budget. So we are giving you a brief. We'll be coming out with a new stock list probably by 20th March. Okay, so but after what happens is the year ending of 31st December, most of the results starts coming from 15 January. And the last day, as per the audit system, the last day to declare results is 15th March. So we observe all the results by the 15th of March. We also see the performance in the last 3 months. And then we give you a good new list. So a new list will be coming out, a new shares, new list will be coming out on by 20th March. So watch out for the seminar which we will do during 20th March. We will give you new shares to invest in. Okay, so every time when we will give you the idea that which shares are good and where you have to invest. Some of them will be same, some of new sectors will be rising and new shares will be coming in, which performance have come, results have come very well. So we'll be announcing every 1.5, 2 months. Last time we gave about 1.5 months back the list. Now we are again giving a list for after budget. So the next list will be given on 20th March. So every 1, 1.5 months, we'll be giving you a list where you can put your investments into, which shares are performing, which has good fundamentals. So we'll give you the list. So if you focus your investments on the shares which we have told you, you will see that you will have a greater return. Okay? What is the, how many people have already invested in our shares, which we had recommended before? If you have invested when we have told you to invest, so I'm sure that you must have made good money, Mr. Jayamurthy. Right? Anybody else who invested GNFC? Mr. Anantharaman, you must have made good money in GNFC. So they were good shares, right? So, these are good fundamentally strong shares which has multi-bagger type, which can give you great returns. We also give you the sectors. Okay. So that's good. Thank you all. You have been investing in our shares, so that's good. So Infra Telecom, again, there is Stretch. It's a new share which has come out after budget. It has risen by about 12%. Okay. Mr. Vishnu, you can see our videos on YouTube. You put Shailesh Sharaf and you see the videos, the shares which we had recommended. The day we had recommended, you check the price and you check the price today. So you will be very happy that, and those are fantastic shares. So if you hold on to those shares, you'll make a lot of, probably you'll make good money. Okay? Stretch is a great share, pretty decent P ratio and fantastic institution base. So Stretch in Infra Telecom is a great share. Even, Fincables. So these two shares I highly recommend. They have been going up even after post-budget. Benefits to realty sector, cements. The government proposes to complete 1 crore houses. Obviously, we will require cements. We will require a lot of infrastructure materials. Affordable housing will be given infrastructure status. Owing to surplus liquidity, banks have started doing lending rates on housing. So there's a huge benefit to the realty sector. So is the cement, if you see, after budget, cement has risen by 15%. Only the concern is the P ratio is very high. JK Cement looks pretty decent. The P ratio is 23.
Today also it rose by 8%.
Okay, today also it rose by 8%. JK Cement is a good investment. So think about JK Cement because the P ratio is low, it can give you a good upside. And obviously, Birla Corporation has been doing very well. Less performance after budget, but the P ratio is 21. So JK Cement looks like a good bet. You can invest in the cement industry. So there are certain things which is very, very important. Again, I repeat, you have to know the sectors. The issue which I have note, don't be a person where you are fixed with certain shares. Keep seeing which sectors are performing and keep churning your portfolio. Okay, so if you know that these sectors have not been performing or these sectors after budget have not been performing, so you have to know a very important time that okay, I have to change my sector, I have to change my shares. Okay, so you can send us a mail. We also give you a portfolio thing. You send us a mail and we'll give you a portfolio checker that which shares are not good or which shares are not good. So you will have a better understanding that how you can change sectors and where you can invest. Okay. I'll take some questions before I move along. I have some questions. Mr. Sugantan, all these stocks are long-term investing. These shares are fantastic fundamental, Mr. Sugantan. So all these stocks are for long-term investing. You can buy these shares and you can keep these shares. What is D equity?
Debt equity ratio.
That is a debt equity
Common equity
ratio.
ratio.
Okay, this is a debt equity ratio. So where the company debt is very, very, low. What is 11.57?
benefit
So basically, the debts, if you see, the debts have to be low. Now, for Dwarkesh, the debt is slightly high. So you just have to be careful. Any debt ratio below 3 is safe. Now, what is the next question? What about India Cements? Details, yeah? Do we have the details? They are. I'll just tell you about India Cements. I'll tell you, Mr. Roshan Jain. In Agri, what about UPL? Okay. In particular sector, how many stocks of different companies are reasonable to buy? See, I would recommend, that you should invest in about 10 to 12 sectors, and you should invest about 2 to 3 stocks in each sector. So that is a good balance. You should have a portfolio of about 25 shares in about 10 to 12 sectors. So that is a very balanced way. So if certain sectors don't perform or you lose money because of certain government changes, the overall you'll be safer. So keep about 10 to 12 sectors and about 25 stocks. 2 to 3 stocks each sector is good. Okay, that answer your question, Sahil? So in last video, ONGC will rise in February. Yes, Mr. Manoj, the crude oil is not performing. The inventories are rising. So crude oil is still at $51. So there is a time right now, crude is not on a high mode. So you have to be careful with ONGC. So you have to follow crude oil. If crude oil will not rise, then ONGC will not rise. But in the last 15 years, 13 years, in February, crude oil has risen. So when crude oil rises, ONGC also rises because its profitability increases. But right now, crude oil is not rising, so you should have a great knowledge of crude oil. Oh, Mr. Manoj. The next question was, do I still hold on grain industry? Yes, you can hold on. Metals and mining is still, it's not bad. Metals and mining has been performing the last 2-3 months. After budget, it has not performed. It's a very short time. 6-7 days is a very short time. But we wanted to give you a brief that, which sectors are already moving after budget. The markets are still good right now. Today also, even after the interest rate cut, the market went down again. It shot up very strongly. Okay, the emerging market index are very high. The American markets are high. So globally right now, there is no concern as such until unless Trump makes a mistake. Okay, because there was no capital gain tax introduced, so even people are happy keeping their investment in the stock market. So presently right now, we just have to watch out for Trump and IT industry. Rest for India looks pretty good right now. So if you have a change, anything, if you see a change, we will tell you. Right now, the markets are okay. We just have to be careful around 9,000 Nifty, because that is the all-time high, 9,000, 9,100. So at that time, if you are getting a good return of about 50%, 100% in any stocks, then you can exit. So it also depends that how much return are you getting from your investment. And that is critical. So don't be greedy. So sometimes we have a habit of, if we get a 40-50% return, we tend to exit that stock. Next one. What about transportation, pharma, Lupin? Mr. Thomas, they are all in futures. We are not covering futures, see. Okay, I see many stocks recommend are trading at 52. Obviously, it will trade, Mr. Ankur, because the markets are also made a new high, all-time high. If you see the small cap index, it's made all-time high. So when the markets are high, the shares are pretty high. So it will already make new 52 weeks high. These are good shares, so they will have more chances of making more future 52 weeks high, Ankur. But because the fundamentals are very strong, we are still very safe. You just have to check the P ratio of certain stocks. So if the P ratio is low, then you don't have to worry. It can still give you a lot of return. Okay? You can only have to worry when the P ratio goes above 35, 40. Till 25, those companies are still good to invest. Is it necessary to put stop loss for investment portfolio? Mr. Vijaya, risk management is very critical. So risk management theory is not a very easy theory to understand. So it depends on the market. So once we know a certain trend, global trend, or the India trend is moving towards sell, so that is the time we also keep money in cash. So we do that. We do that. So it depends on where is the market. So it depends on many factors. So if the market is going up, we tend to hold on. We don't panic. So we tend to hold on. So even if the share goes down, we hold on because we know that the trend and the indicators of the market is still up. Right now, all the indicators are up. We are not seeing any indicator which is showing down right now. Again, this one.
76% pledges.
Okay, India Cement, somebody asked, the problem with this company is it has a pledge of 76%.
Institution is good.
Yeah, but are they? Data are
Yeah.
There are people asking for other shares also. UPL, So, India Cement, the pledge is 76%. So I have a concern about when the pledge is 76%, I try to be away from those stocks. We will tell you, Mr. Amit, about UPL. My company, my team is going on to check. Why this crude rise in Jan-February? It rises because of the America, you know, because of the winters in America. You know, that's why it rises. That is one of the biggest reasons for crude rise in January and February. Mr. Roshan Jain will discuss about Banco. With today's RBI policy, will PCB banks go down? Right now, the market was supposed to go down, but again, it has gone up. So we are right now in a pretty good bull market, and there are no indicators which is showing a sell sign right now. So, you know, when the sell signs will come, we will inform. In the morning report, if you're checking our morning reports, we will inform in the morning report that the sell signs are incoming. Can I buy Dhampur Sugar? Yes, we told you, you can buy Dhampur Sugar. Can we invest in the stocks at current market value? Yes, you can. Just be careful because of the P ratio. And because the markets are high, it might give you a sharp correction. But you need to have the appetite and the risk ability to hold those stocks. Kajaria Ceramic, the problem with Kajaria Ceramic is very high P, extremely high P, Mr. Nanil Nagesh. The logistics sector will do well because the government is very strong on the transportation area. They have combined all the areas. If you observe the airlines, the railways, the roads, ships, all have been combined into one transport. So government has a very strong focus on the transport area. So that will definitely do well. Logistics and transport will do well. When RBI decided not to cut rates, which stocks to gain? That's a very short-term question, Mr. Ankur. You know, focus on the fundamentals of shares. Focus on the main universal truth, the pillars, which is the fundamental. Once the fundamentals are strong, you are safe to invest in those stocks. Okay? Is short selling legal? Yeah, you can sell. Yes, Mr. Sugananthan, it's legal. But be very careful. Sir, your view about Indian Bank. Indian Bank is a great share. It has risen a lot in the last year. You know, Indian Bank, if you see, you know, the P ratio is also only 11. The P ratio of Indian Bank is only 11. It has risen a lot and it's great. There are a lot of institutions into it. 137 institutions have invested this. It's a great buy. If 137 institutions, financial institutions have bought it, then it makes sense that we should also have Indian Bank in our portfolio. What does pledge mean? Pledge means that the corporate, the company's owner has given his shares in the bank and taken a loan. Okay, so because he's taken a loan, that means there is some shortage of cash supply. Because nobody will like to share, he's just pledging his own share. So that means that the company's cash flow, maybe the profits are up, they are showing, maybe the stock prices are going up, but fundamentally it has some dangerous line. Because the pledge is so high.
UPL, 28% rise from last 20% in last budget, and
EPS
growth is also there.
Okay, whether we need to consider debt equity? Yes, you need to. Any debt equity ratio above 3 may be dangerous. Only PSU banks and financial institutions, their debt ratio is high because of their nature of business. So in the thing, you should always, you know, any small company, any other sectors, any ratio above 3 is not very, very safe. So you have to be careful how much is the debt. Right? It should not be more than 3. What about Infosys, Mr. Saloni? As I said, right now our IT companies is at the mercy of Donald Trump. So if the Senate passes the law and increases the salary from $65,000 to $130,000, we have to be careful. We have to be careful. UPL, somebody asked, it's a great share, it's a decent share. The P ratio is 23. There is a growth, the growth is up, you know. So it's a good share. UPL is a good share to invest. Can you comment on Nifty Life? Can you comment on Future Lifestyle Fashion?
Future Lifestyle Fashion.
Nothing to worry right now, Mr. Chirag. Right now the market, after the news, it again has gone up. So we have to wait for 1 or 2 days whether there is a negative impact or not. But because the market has sharply gone up and right now we don't see any even global cues that the market will go down. So maybe at 9,000 level we need to be more careful. But if you are profiting in certain shares or 70-80%, 50%, you should exit. Don't be greedy, that's a good run. How do you subscribe? Just register in our website, Mr. Jayamurthy, and you'll get a morning report. Dynamiclevels.com. Just register me and you will get the morning report every day. Okay. Doubtful logistics Indian Oil Corporation is good for long bet. Morphin. See, the pledge is very high. Morphin Lab, right?
Mm-hmm.
Where is it? Morphin, if you see, the P ratio is very high, so I recommend not to invest in the share. The P ratio is very high. So if you want to invest, maybe let the price go down from 23, you buy at the levels of 15 rupees, 16 rupees, not right now. Because the P ratio is very high. Okay, Future Lifestyle, not a good share. Again, pledge is 70% and P is 99. So the share is not good at all. Do not invest in Future Lifestyle. A GNA XL, Chirag is asking, just tell me about GNA XL. Is Banan Finance is a good bet at the current price? Bajaj Finance, Ratana.
Bajaj Finance.
What is the most important to know? Look in fundamental. What is the most important thing to look in fundamental? Just check here. Okay, how many institutions have invested in that share? So you're very safe. Once you know, it's a great question. What are the things to see when you check fundamentals? How many institutions have actually bought those shares? So if you know, 20, 30 institutions have bought those shares, then 20 institutions cannot make a mistake on a particular share. Then the P ratio is very important, the debt equity ratio is very important, pledge is very important. You should know whether the company is giving dividend yields or not. Certain companies, if they're not giving dividend yields, you have to be careful. Okay, what is the market capitalization? So these are some of the very important parameters we should have a knowledge. Okay, Mr. Vijay, Bank Nifty is at 30 P. Is it safe to invest in banks? Yeah, right now, no problem. The markets are okay right now. GNXL here. Which site are you guys checking? We have our own site, dynamiclevels.com. So we check our own site for fundamentals. Ankur. You can also check in BSC and NSEIndia.com. Okay, Mr. Hart Zaveri, you can invest in the stock market, but you have to be careful because the markets are at very high. So it might give a sharp correction. Okay, because you're first time in the market, you can wait for a correction and then invest in the markets. If you can have the ability to hold on and you will not panic with your money, then you can buy right now and wait. GNXL is okay.
Fundamentally good performance, no performance.
Okay, the problem with GNXL is the fundamentally it's okay, but there is no price performance. So when there is no price performance, our investment gets stuck. Our investment gets stuck. If the P ratio is low, less chance that the share will fall. Correct. Because the P ratio is low, definitely the shares will fall less. Pledge means for company purpose, Mr. Roshan. They have done the pledge and used probably for the company purpose until unless the owner of the company is a cheat. Bank of Baroda, batate. You, Mr. Naresh, you can get all the pledge info from my website, dynamiclevels.com. Okay, I'll check, So we'll give the list of stocks, Ms. Anila. What is LTP? LTP is last traded price. ZTV and Sun TV. Batal. And Saturn. Saturn.
Saturn.
Saturn. Win Financial Services.
Saturn.
Can you tell like the maximum value of F2 in open interest? This is a study on budget, so we'll discuss open interest later.
Bajaj Finance.
Okay, Bajaj Finance, the P is 34. And institutions are 588 individual. It's a performance stock, but the P ratio is slightly high. You can get from our website, Mr. Love Kumar.
Zeal 50% 50 P ratio. 42% pledge. No issues.
42% pledge. Z.
And 50 rupees. 50 is P ratio.
Okay, Z is where the P ratio is very, very high. So I will not recommend Z right now. Very, very high P. Mr. Chirag, you can be in touch with my team. And, if you have a portfolio or something, you can send it to my team. And then, support@dynamiclevels.com. And then, because I support big portfolios, my team supports small portfolios. So if you have a big portfolio, I'll get in touch with you. Glenmark
Parmesan?
What will be the impact of not having a rate cut on banking stocks? See, what happens is whenever there is a rate cut, there is a pressure on the banks, to reduce their rate, which affects the profitability. So when there is no rate cut, their profitability becomes intact. That is one area to see. Another area to see is that sometimes, because there is a rate cut, the entire industry benefits, so there is a huge demand. So the banks also, the rate cut, but the demand increases. So it's a catch-22 situation. Okay, so please send Mr. Chirag to my team and then I'll get in touch with you. Any other question on the... Okay, we give training on technical analysis, Mr. Malesh. You please send a mail in support@dynamiclevels.com. I'll be probably doing a course in Kolkata, a two-day course where I'll be teaching you fundamentals and technicals on stocks, on Nifty, on Bank Nifty. You can join that session if you want to.
But recovering from last two quarters.
Okay, Bank of Baroda is recovering from last two quarters, still negative PAT, but recovering from last two quarters. Okay, the two-day training is right now. We have to start with 2 days and then we have to practice. Okay, so after 2 days, we are also available to help you to, make it practically how to implement those ideas on the stock market on a daily basis. You please mail us and we'll answer that question. Okay, we'll be teaching you about how to identify stocks, how to identify fundamentals in a detailed manner, technical analysis, so many things will be done when we do the sessions. Can you repeat? support@dynamiclevels.com. Nalco, bata, what is what Nalco? I'll tell you about Nalco.
Nalco P ratio is 24. And else everything is good.
Nalco is a great share, so you can invest in Nalco.
And
it's a performing share, it's a great share.
Sun Pharma, non-performing.
That is a very, you know, levels to buy Manappuram. You go to dynamiclevels.com. There is a ladder which will tell you when you can buy.
Gold is rising, so...
Okay, and another thing is gold is rising. So when gold rises, Manappuram also tends to rise a lot. You should have a good knowledge of gold. Then you should start trading in Manappuram, Mr. Thomas.
No performance since last question.
Sun Pharma, there has not been a price performance, you know. It has been a no performer stock. It is better to invest in Jubilant, RPG Life, rather than in Sun Pharma. Okay. So again, as I said last time, have a great knowledge about the sector. Okay. Once you have a knowledge about the sector, you should also have a great knowledge about the shares in that sector, which is the best performing with low P ratio, profitable companies, no pledge, no debt equity ratio, and then you have invested in a good sector and a good stock. Okay, performing sector, good stock is the key to make money in the stock market. Okay, why is this? There are many reasons, Mr. Vamsi, why certain bad shares also perform. You know, companies pay, when the market is high, there is a lot of manipulation in the market. The company tends to buy those shares. Okay, certain people who don't have knowledge, they get information from the market, they buy. So when the market falls, those shares can be very, very dangerous. Right? When we give you certain shares, our share will fall maybe 10%, and those stocks which not good fundamentals will fall maybe 30-40%. So that is why when you are in good fundamental stocks, you are very, very safe. Okay. What is interest coverage? Interest coverage. Where is that in our?
No, we are not providing because we are taking good debt equity companies. So we are not providing. We are covering the debt.
By price performance, do you mean up and down? Yeah, yes. The price is up and down, definitely. Which private bank stock is good to invest? We don't have any private banks,
no?
In the cash management market, we don't have any private banks, but in the F&O segment, future segment, there are a lot of private banks where you can invest.
That.
Yes Bank is great.
Yes, yes, we will cover it next time.
Okay.
Nalco?
Is it worthwhile to invest?
Yes.
What is the P ratio of Bajaj Finserv? Tell me right now. Bajaj Finserv is a great share, definitely Alpana. I'll tell you the P ratio right now.
P ratio is 26.
Okay, still the P ratio is 26. So Bajaj Finserv is still a great company. The fundamentals are fantastic. It's a great share to invest in. Okay, there is a section which gives entry in target and intraday which time frame. Can we get the stock's fundamental data on the format on dynamic levels? Yes, we have, right? In this format, you know, this has been specially done for you in the presentation, but you have a similar format in the website, right?
Maybe when you have discrete format.
You have different
data. All the data.
All the data, because here we are just giving a summary, na?
Yeah.
We are having details.
Okay. What about in education sector? Z-Learn.
Z to we just now said, na?
Z Learn and NIT. Where do we get open internet in nscindia.com, Mr. Rishabh?
Good. Good.
Next time, what we will do? We will also give you, you know, we will also have the, you know, the future stocks ready, so we can also tell you about the future stocks immediately. But the cash stocks tends to rise more. The multi-baggers become in cash stocks. So the, you have a greater chance of making greater money in the cash stocks. In the overview,
there was one question regarding the where do you get the ladder, right? The support and resistance for stocks. I think Ankur, where can I find the ladder on dynamic levels? So when you go to the stock section on our website and there is an overview. You have support and resistance levels for 16
minutes. If you need any help, you just give a call and then we'll do it. Somebody will help you. Okay, so any other further questions? Can we dish TV video con? No, the Rishabh does not include USD INR. The open interest data does not include USD INR. Gen Education,
Gen Education, a good company, 21%.
That's a good company, 21.
Plus 21% and P ratio is 24.
P ratio is 24. Gen Education is a good company.
Performance result is good.
Glenmark. Result is good. Performance Glenmark.
Dish TV has pledge of 61%.
Dish TV.
Yeah.
Dish TV has a pledge of 61%. I don't recommend to invest in that share. Okay. And what about Glenmark Pharma? Cipla and IGL also. People are asking questions about the stocks. How many people are there? 83. Okay, as I can again repeat, keep your investment in 10 to 12 sectors and invest and know which are the top sectors and invest 2 or 3 stocks from that sector, the top performing stocks. This is how you should always have your, you know, strategy. If you have big funds, you can put 15 sectors and 45 stocks.
Cipla is high P, it's 46 P.
Cipla is 46 P ratio, I don't recommend. Banco products, batana. You can get it in YouTube, Manish. What is the holding period? The holding period depends on the risk management. So if there is a trend which is still going up, we tend to hold. And then after 50-60%, if you got a return, you can even exit. Okay, that's one area to see. If you know, sometimes, you know, when the market is going up and up and up, and you don't sell, and the market sharply goes down, there is a... So about 50-100%, and also it depends on the sector and on the trend analysis. Usually we have seen the buy trend continues for longer duration. The buy trend has a tendency to be at 40 days, 60 days, 80 days, even 100 days. But the sell trend does not remain more than 7 to 9 days. Right? So buy trend has much, much bigger thing. Banco is a great share. Banco has no problem. DCB Bank, Federal Bank. Recommending Sterling, Dick. Sterling Tools.
Is it in
NSE? Is it in NSE? Russian. Some companies' P ratio is not mentioned, is it? companies P ratio is not mentioned. In my presentation, all P ratio is mentioned.
Not in the slides.
Where do we see separate data for US dashboard? NSEIndia.com. You can go to NSEIndia.com. KTK Bank.
Sterling Tool is a good company with low P.
Sterling Kind is a good company. Sterling Tools, low P and performing.
Performance
is also good. अपने कौन से सेक्टर में? कौन से कैटेगरी में? Just tell me the category. It's a good share. Right now, what you are asking, we are seeing in the database. We have a huge database. So my team is seeing in the database and telling you whether it's a good company or not. The third webinar on open data is option not isn't flagged. Means what? P is not mentioned on sites like MoneyGram. What should we do? P is not mentioned. P is mentioned in every site, Manoj. Please check. It's mentioned. It's also in Money Control. It's also on our site.
If the PATs are negative, then they provide the zero P.
If the PATs are negative, then it is zero P or dash. There is the PAT is negative. Because if there is no profit, how can they be priced P? P is price earning ratio. So if there is no earning, there will be no P ratio. There has to be earning and there has to be a price. Then only you can have a P ratio. How to know bond price? You also you can go to RBI and check the bond prices. And you can also go to NSEIndia.com. They also provide bond prices. Okay, my question is, will go from 200 to 1200 as read by? It's a good stock, Sterling Tools. So it has a potential to go up. Whether it will go to 1200 or not, there are many, many factors. Yes, you can refer Mr. Gopinath to P ratio. What is your viewpoint on DHFL? Just ask DHFL.
Give some data.
DHFL is good. My company is with, they are very excited. My team Arnav, Vikash, Arnav is very excited. DHFL is a good company. Okay, so we are at the end of the thing. In Money Control, supply is 53, you told 46. Yeah, it keeps changing with the price, Mr. Gopinath. As the price changes, the P ratio changes on a daily basis. Okay?
Yes.
Will Patanjali just share? I don't know. You have to ask
Ramdev
Baba Roshan. I don't know whether Patanjali will list or not. 25th January is not flagged on you on YouTube. Is there?
No, it is right there.
Yeah, this recording will say it. Okay? Harita Seatings. Okay, last one. Harita Seatings.
DHFL
does provide a P. Okay, DHFL, the P is only 10. It's a great share. And it's a performing stock. Very, very good stock, DHFL. Okay, Glenmark. Glenmark, quickly. And Harita Seatings.
Harita Seatings has low volume, but.
Harita Seatings, the problem is very low volumes.
Yeah, depth is very low. The P ratio is also good. And
the company is good, but the volumes are not good, so very difficult to buy and share in the market. Also, can you take commodity class also in future webinars? Yeah, we'll think, Mr. Gopinath, we'll think wherever we will take. Okay, so let's put an end. What about Alankit? What is a good stock in tire industry? JK Tire is very good. What are the shares? We have JK Tire. and TVS GD, that also Balkrishna Industries and JK Tyre. After budget, the sector is not performing, so we'll see. The auto sector has not performed after the budget.
Alankit is not a good company. Negative PAT. Then again.
Negative PAT. Alankit, Roshan, don't invest. It has negative PAT. P ratio is very high. And which P ratio is better to buy? Low or high range? Obviously low, Mr. Santosh Kumar. If the profitability is come and the P ratio is low, that means the price can still go up. Okay, so it's time, 4:30. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for your time. Thank you so much for your time. So maybe we'll have a seminar maybe next week or next to next week. So we'll inform you. Please join. Thank you.